Good morning everyone and welcome to today's market commentary. We are on Nifty daily time frame chart and we can see that Nifty is making new high today. It has crossed R2 of this month. This is the monthly pivot point at 10,891, and in the previous session itself on 19th of Jan we could see a close above this R2, and today the opening has also happened near the same zone and it is making a new high as of today. So in previous sessions where we were seeing the bearish divergence, that is also getting ruled out now. So at that point, RSI was 77.86 and now it is 77.65. At any moment, it can cross above this previous RSI, and the bearish divergence which we were talking of connecting these highs and then connecting the highs of RSI, that is also getting ruled out now. So one thing is Nifty is it is trading above R2, the monthly pivot point. So Nifty is trading above the monthly pivot point R2, and in RSI, the bearish divergence on daily time frame is almost to get ruled out. If we go to weekly time frame, so if we go to weekly time frame and see the earlier Fibonacci trend extension which we marked, so here we have connected this low with this high and again with this low. This is a bullish rally, small retracement, and again a bullish rally. Now we can see that Nifty is trading exactly at the 1.414 level. Now the value of that level is 10,923.86. So on first hand, that can act as a mild resistance for Nifty, although 1.414 has a less significance than the other levels such as 1.618. So there could be a small resistance at this point, 10,922. Now enabling the pivot points, since we are on weekly time frame, we'll be getting the pivot points for this whole year. And here you can see that R1 of this year is in confluence with 1.618. So finally, this year 11,361 is the major resistance that Nifty can face, and as of now 1.414 can act as small resistance for Nifty, which is 10,923. And we came to that conclusion because we drew this Fibonacci trend extension from March 2016 to now, so connecting the low of that month with the high of September 2016 and again the low of December 2016, and it is exactly trading at 1.414. Now on weekly time frame, we still have that bearish divergence. Connecting the highs of the price and connecting the highs of RSI. So we still have our bearish divergence intact on weekly time frame, and we expect by the time it comes to 11,361, then the bearish divergence would get activated. And if any small movement is, if any small U-turn is seen at this level, 11,361, we can expect bearishness then to start. And all this could happen by the time this quarter gets ended, because this is the results quarter. And by the end of this quarter, we can see a U-turn in Nifty. So on weekly time frame, it is trading at 1.414 level and bearish divergence is intact. And on daily time frame, it is trading above R2, and the bearish divergence in daily time frame is almost getting invalidated. It just need to close above 78. RSI needs to close above 78. So we were connecting these highs actually. So here it was 77.86, and now RSI is at 77.68. So just a difference of 0.2. If RSI closes above the previous high, then the bearish divergence gets invalidated. This is the story on daily time frame. Let's move to smaller time frame. That is hourly. And I'm removing the Fibonacci tool also. So on hourly time frame, we can see a clear bearish divergence in Nifty. So connecting the earlier highs. And highs of RSI. A very clear bearish divergence is seen in Nifty. Let us also enable the pivot points. So it is trading in between central pivot point and R1. So based on pivot points, it is in the bullish zone as of this week, because this is just the starting session of this week. And since we are on hourly time frame, these pivots are valid for the whole week. So it is in between this zone. So this is a bullish zone as far as these pivot points are considered. But we can see a bearish divergence in Nifty on hourly time frame, connecting the highs of the price and connecting the highs of RSI. So there is a weakness in this rally. Now going forward, we'll change this to classical pivot points. Now going forward, this zone will act as strong resistance for Nifty 10,960, because that is prior week's R4 and this week's R1, which is 10,978. These are the major resistances for Nifty for this week. Now if we can see a reversal now itself, and if we could see a close below the open of today. Now open of today is 10,883.2. In hourly time frame itself, if we could see a U-turn and a close below today's open, then a bearish rally can be seen in Nifty at least until 10,822 on first hand. And again, we have this strong support zone, the gap zone of earlier session. On 17th, and comparing it with 18th, we had a gap up. And that gap was covered on the same day itself. We marked this level as this support, and at the same zone we could see a bounce back. Now the same zone can act as a strong support for Nifty even today, if at all there is a U-turn and there is a close below today's open. And on the upper hand, since Nifty is making a bearish divergence, we have prior week's R4 and this week's R1 as a strong resistance for Nifty. So the zone is 10,960 to 10,980. So this zone is the resistance zone for Nifty, and 10,822 to 10,802 is the support zone for Nifty. And on hourly time frame, we can see a clear bearish divergence in Nifty. And price is also approaching the upper channel of Bollinger Bands. And once it touches the upper channel of Bollinger Bands, this bearish divergence will also get activated. And then we can see a good reversal from Nifty. Just to remind you, 10,923 is the 1.414 level on weekly Fibonacci trend extension. So weekly Fibonacci trend extension and this RSA bearish divergence along with the upper channel of Bollinger Band. These three things when combined, we can see a reversal in Nifty, at least for a short term. So I'm repeating it again. 10,923 was the Fibonacci 1.414 extension, which we saw on weekly time frame. And on hourly time frame, we can also see a bearish divergence and the price is approaching the upper channel of Bollinger Bands. So a small reversal can be seen in Nifty as of now. So this is the story on hourly time frame. Now going to 15 minute time frame, even on 15 minutes we can see the bearish divergence and price is facing this R1, intraday R1 as the resistance. Intraday R1 is at 10,937 and this bearish divergence, at the same time price is trading near the upper channel of Bollinger Bands. We could see these both channels diverging since 19th of Jan itself. Since many sessions now, the price is trading near the upper channel of Bollinger Bands. Now many Nifty should face many resistance on the upper side. First is intraday R1. Second, bearish divergence on 15 minute time frame. Third, this 10,923 level, which is Fibonacci 1.414 trend extension, as well as the upper channel of Bollinger Bands. These all things may act as resistance in Nifty. Now, since the opening candle, we could see a long rally, price opening at 10,883 and making a new high of 10,926. After that, we could not see any of the candle on 15 minute time frame closing above the first 15 minute high. So this first 15 minute high we can take as opening range, and there's no opening range breakout as of now. Now since there are many resistance on the upper side, we could see a U-turn from here, and as told earlier, the 10,883 is the first support for Nifty because that is the opening of today, and there is also resistance being faced at that price since 18th of January. That day, this level acted as resistance, and again for the second time price came there and we saw a U-turn. Now again, that zone can act as support this time, resistance becoming support. If price closes below this level, again we have central pivot point for our rescue, and again this 20 period moving average. Finally, S1 is our next support. So on intraday time frame, I'm repeating it again, 10,923, which is weekly Fibonacci extension, 10,923, that is in confluence with this RSA bearish divergence, upper channel of Bollinger Bands, and R1 of intraday. there are about four resistances in intraday time frame. And if price takes a U-turn from here, we have today's opening price 10,883 as our first support, central pivot point as second support, 20 period moving average as the third support. Now, if I draw a horizontal line at this level, you can see there is a support, there is a resistance already being made. So this resistance will now become support, and this support is in confluence with 20 period moving average. If price closes even further below that, we have S1. Now, this S1 of today, you can see that that was a natural support in the earlier session. So this is also a good support for Nifty on 15 minute time frame. So this is the story of Nifty on 15 minute time frame. Now let's move to our next index, which is Bank Nifty. So even Bank Nifty is trading above R2 of this month pivot point. The same, let's go to weekly time frame, remove the pivot points as of now and draw the Fibonacci trend extension. So in Bank Nifty is now trading at 1.272 weekly Fibonacci trend extension. Value for that is 26,719, and as of now Bank Nifty is at 26,933. Price closed above this 1.272 level last week itself, and now at it is at the verge of taking a U-turn. It is trading at Bollinger Band upper channel and as well as near the 1.272 level. So there is no pivot point resistance also nearby. The only resistance that it can face is the upper channel of Bollinger Bands, because it is also, it is already closed above this 1.272. There are little chances that it can take a U-turn from here. And we'll get confirmation only by the end of this week. And there is also expiry in this week, which is on 25th Jan. So by the end of the expiry, we can get a clear signal if price is going to take a U-turn or not. So this Bank Nifty is at a very crucial level now. On weekly, this is the story of Bank Nifty. And on daily time frame, it is trading above R2 as told earlier. And today, at this point, it is trying to form a doji, but we cannot say this at this moment. We need to wait until at least the end of today's session. So our this pivot points and Fibonacci, we are clear of that. Let's remove the drawing tools. Let's see if we can draw any trend line resistances for Bank Nifty connecting the prior highs. So based on trend line resistance, it has already surpassed the trend line resistance, and on weekly time frame we still have this bearish divergence intact even on Bank Nifty, connecting the highs of price and connecting the highs of RSI. So we still have this bearish divergence intact. Thank you. Next thing is that when we drew this trend line connecting the prior highs, so already price crossed that, and since last few sessions it took support near the trend line, and then again we could see a bounce back. Last week there was a good large green candle. This was the up move made. So on weekly time frame, there is bearish divergence and price is trading above the trend line resistance. And on daily time frame, Bank Nifty is still having that bearish divergence connecting the earlier highs. Connecting the highs of RSI. So this is the bearish divergence being followed by Bank Nifty, and it gets invalidated only when RSI crosses 84.24. As of now, RSI is at 77.91. So in Nifty, we could see that Bank Nifty got this bearish divergence is almost getting ruled out, and in Bank Nifty, it still needs. It still needs to make a good move on the upside as far as this RSI is considered. So on daily time frame, we don't have any pivot resistance as of now. R3 is almost near 27,630, and it is trading in between R2 and R3. Only thing, the important point on daily time frame is the bearish divergence being made. Price trading at upper channel of Bollinger Bands. It is not only trading near the upper channel, it is trading above the upper channel of Bollinger Bands now. So there should be a mean reversion happening as of now. Mean reversion in the sense it needs to take a U-turn, and when it takes a U-turn, this level 26,472 is the next level of support for Bank Nifty. In Bank Nifty also, we have this bearish divergence on hourly time frame. So connecting the earlier highs. Of price and highs of RSI. So we can see a clear bearish divergence even in Bank Nifty. We don't have any pivot resistance as of now. Only thing is it is trading at 1.2721 weekly time frame. So even on hourly time frame, the only thing, the only important point which we can see is the bearish divergence. And if you see the first candle, we are on hourly time frame, so the first candle is a doji. Near doji, not the complete doji here. So the high of this doji and the low of this doji are now very important price levels. If price breaks the high, we can see a good up move, and if price breaks the low of this candle, we can see a good down move in Bank Nifty. And if Bank Nifty goes down, it will take Nifty also along with that. So if you can see, the high of this candle, this doji, and the low of this candle are in confluence now. So this becomes a very important price level for Bank Nifty now, 26,850. So on hourly time frame, this is the very important point that we observed. First candle is doji, and there is bearish divergence in Bank Nifty. So even in 15 minute time frame chart, we can see that bearish divergence is there. So whatever up move that is being made by both the indices, there is no strength in that. That is what this bearish divergence is telling us. From here, the today's session is started. And now, if we can see a red candle here, that would become an evening star pattern. This being the shooting star of this three candle pattern. So on 15 minute time frame also, what we are seeing is price trading at upper channel of Bollinger band, and there is an RSI bearish divergence here. And this was the story of both the indices, and the stock that we picked up today is Just Dial. We have results of Just Dial today, and we did some analysis on that. So going to daily time frame, now connecting the high of this candle with the high of this candle, we could draw a trend line resistance. The prior trend line resistance is now acting as support. Here it is. For this session, for the 18th January session and 19th January session, this trend line, the prior trend line resistance acted as trend line support. And we also have this horizontal resistance. Here for the first time, the price acted as resistance. Again, going forward, this was the second time where it acted as resistance. Here for some sessions, it acted as resistance, and that zone is now becoming support for us. Even on trend line and even on horizontal level, the resistance is now acting as support. These are the two observations on first hand. And thirdly, the 20 period moving average, that is also acting as support as of now. That was the third point for us. Fourth point was this R1 of month. Since we are on daily time frame, the pivot points that we are seeing here are monthly pivot points. So this monthly R1 is also acting as fourth support for us. And that is the reason we could see a good up move around 3% of movement since yesterday. We could see now. And we also have the results of Just Dial today. So these are all the reasons for the up move in Just Dial. The next stock that we can see is UPL. So UPL drawing the high, connecting the highs of these candles, we have a trend line resistance, and price closed above that trend line resistance. So that is the reason we could see a good gap up in UPL as of today. Now, one more thing what we need to observe here is we have a trend line resistance coming. So connecting the highs of all these candles, we have a trend line resistance coming up here. And that trend line resistance is in confluence with 0.618 level, which is 820.13. So we hope that 829 or 820.13 will act as a strong resistance for UPL. And above that, we also have monthly R2 at 827.18. Even if it takes a U-turn from here, this level, monthly R1 as well as 0.5 retracement level at around 790, that can act as strong support for UPL. So resistance is 820 to 827 and support is at 793 to 790. And how did we draw this Fibonacci retracement? I'm just removing the pivot points. So on this chart, the visible high made was this on 1st of 8th month, on 1st of August, and I'm connecting that with the low made in the December. So this retracement, we could see an up move here, and finally it managed to cross the 0.5 level, and the next resistance that it could face is 0.618. And at this 0.618, we already have this trend line resistance in, and there is also 0.618. Above this, we have the pivot point. So these three things can make UPL face a small resistance. If the price takes a U-turn at this zone, we have the R1 in confluence with 0.5 retracement that acting as a strong support for UPL. And this earlier trend line resistance will now act as support. So these three things will act as a good support here, and these three things will act as good resistance for UPL on the upside. So these are all the stocks and indices for today. Thank you all for joining today's market commentary.